إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says on the tongue of His Messenger in a form of complaint, in a form of complaint, shakwa yani. وقال الرسول يا رب إن قوم اتخذوا هذا القرآن مهجورا وقال الرسول يا ربي يا ربي إن قوم اتخذوا هذا القرآن مهجورا And the messenger said, My Lord, my people abandoned the Quran. الآية لها خصوص نزلت في قريش في الكافرين منهم. The ayah has a special reason. It was revealed regarding the disbelievers of Quraysh because they would not listen to the Quran. They would rather advise one another not to listen to the Quran. وقال الذين كفروا لا تسمعوا لهذا القرآن والغوا فيه لعلكم تغلبون And the disbelievers would say to one another, Do not listen to the Quran, and when it's recited, make noise. ولكن كما يقول جمهور المفسرين, But the majority of the scholars of tafsir, they say, لَيْسَ الْعِبْرَةِ بِخُصُوصِ السَّبَبِ وَلَكِنَّ الْعِبْرَةِ بِعُمُومِ اللَّفْظِ When we look at the Qur'an, we still have to apply its apparent meaning, the apparent meaning of the words. So this verse also applies to Muslims who abandoned the Qur'an. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Al-Quran, Kalamullah, is the speech of Allah, the spoken words of Allah. قَالَ تَعَالَى Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنْ أَحَدٌ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ اسْتَجَارَكَ فَأَجِرْهِ حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ أي Al-Quran. Al-Quran, brothers and sisters in Islam, is the message from Allah to you. Allah sent you it. Why are you neglecting it? Why are you abandoning it? I can just imagine if a president of a country would send to any of us a letter, what we will do with that letter. Read it over and over again. Malikul Muluk, the king of the kings, sent you that letter, sent you this message, sent you that Quran. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is complaining because he knows what the Quran is all about. He loved it. Da'a Rabbah an yaj'al al-Quran al-Karim rabi'a qalbi. Kama thabat hadith hassanahu ba'd ahli al-ilm. He said, "O Allah, make the Quran the spring of my heart, wa nura sadri, and the light of my chest." Abdullah ibn Abbas, ya ikhwa, says, "كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما أخرج البخاري كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود الناس." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to be the most generous of all people. But his generosity would increase, would reach its peak when he mingles with the Quran more. وكان أجود ما يكون في رمضان حين يأتيه جبريل فيدارسه القرآن. Jibril alayhi salam, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, he used to come every Ramadan to review all the Quran that was revealed so far. He loved it so much that he actually asked Jibril alayhi salam, "Why don't you come more often? Why don't you bring more often Quran to me?" Wal hadith fil Bukhari, kitab al tafsir. Also, Abdullah ibn Abbas says, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لجبريل ألا تزورنا ألا تكثر من زيارتنا. Why don't you visit me more often? فأنزل الله سبحانه وتعالى قوله تعالى وما نتنزل إلا بأمر ربك له ما بين أيدينا وما خلفنا وما بين ذلك. Jibril basically is telling the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, "I do not come on my own. Allah must command me to come down." That goes to say to those who say in the name of the Holy Ghost, "U'bud Rabbak," the Lord of the Holy Ghost. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam loved the Quran so much that his character was transformed. As Aisha radiallahu anha was asked, كما في البخاري as well, عن خلقه صلى الله عليه وسلم, فقالت كان خلقه القرآن. His character is the Quran. أقرأت القرآن? Did you read the Quran? Did you recite the Quran? This is the manner of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Even the companions inherited this from him sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They loved the book of Allah. They loved it. And that's why Allah, ya ikhwa, in a record time, elevated them in the dunya before the hereafter. Yani al-hadith hadha fi sahih al-imam Muslim, Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu says, after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq called Abu Umar. فقال له يا عمر, he said, يا عمر, هيا بنا نزور أم أيمن بركة حاضنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Can we go and visit أم أيمن? أم أيمن is the woman who took care of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم after the death of his mother. فإن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يكثر من زيارتها, because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to always visit her. As soon as they arrived, Umm Ayman broke in tears. And Umar and Abu Bakr right away tried to comfort her. And they said to her, Ya Umm Ayman, you know that whatever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is having now is better than the dunya. Ma indallahi khayrun lirasulih. فقالت والله ما على هذا أبكي. She said, by Allah, I'm not crying for this. أنا أعلم, I know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is having a better life than this life. But I'm crying لأن الوحي انقطع من السماء. Because the revelation stopped with his death, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No more Quran, in the sense of revealed. Where are we from the Quran, ya ikhwa? Where are we? In the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam yaqul, Inna Allah yarfa'u bihada al-kitab aqwama wa yad'u akharin. Because of this Quran, Allah elevates people in this dunya. Yani subhanallah, waradat hadhihi al-qissa fi sahih Muslim. This story was mentioned in sahih Muslim. When Umar met Nafi', one of the people, Nafi' ibn al-Harith, one of the people he appointed to be the Amir of Mecca, in another place called Asafan. Fahi asked him, Man istamalt ala ahli al-wadi? Who did you appoint to be your vice in your absence in Mecca? Qala ibn Abza. He said to him, Ibn Abza. Qala wa man ibn Abza? Mean ibn Abza hada? قال مولى من موالينا, a freed slave. Umar tells him, you appoint in leadership a freed slave. قال يا أمير المؤمنين إنه أعلم الناس بكتاب الله. He is the most knowledgeable of the book of Allah. Umar says, أبشر فإني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, I heard the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم says, إن الله يرفع بهذا الكتاب أقواما ويضع آخرين. Allah elevates people because of this book and put down others. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في الصحيحين من حديث عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه, خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. The best of you are those who learn the Quran and teach it. That explains why we're here, brothers and sisters in Islam. هجر القرآن, abandonment or the abandonment of the Quran amongst the Muslims takes five phases or five types. There are five ways to abandon the Quran. Number one, هجر الاستماع, that you don't listen to the Quran. You abandoning listening to the Quran. I have not seen a time when the Quran is available in so many mediums, like now, in your car you can listen to it, at work you can listen to it, in bed you can listen to it. We hardly listen to it, brothers and sisters in Islam. We abandon listening to the Quran, and we got consumed with listening to musics, which is haram. Listen to the talk of the human beings, which is useless sometimes. هجر القرآن, هجر الاستماع. One day, ya ikhwa, كما في البخاري, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called Abu Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه. فقال له, he said to him, يا ابن مسعود, اقرأ علي القرآن. Recite to me the Quran. فقال يا رسول الله, he said, O Messenger of Allah, أَأَقْرَأَهُ عَلَيْكَ وَعَلَيْكَ أُنزِلْ. How am I going to recite it to you when it was revealed to you? فَقَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ, the Prophet صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ says, إِنِّي أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَسْمَعَهُ مِنْ غَيْرِي. I like to hear it from others. فَتَلَى عَلَيْهِ أَوَّلَ النِّسَاءِ, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ حَتَّى قَوْلَهُ تَعَالَى فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَى هَؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا. فَبَكَى صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَقَالَ حَسْبُكَ. He recited the Nisa until the verse, how will it be when we will bring a witness against every nation and will bring you as a witness, O Muhammad, against your qawm, your people. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cried and he said to him, hasbuk, stop yani. Sadaqa Allahu al-Azim hadihi, which they say, la asasala, qul hasbuk, la asasala. Qul lak, sadaqa Allahu al-Azim, hasb, anta la tusad, Allah sadiq ya akha, Allah yasduq. حسبك هذه السنة حسبك. Brothers and sisters in Islam, يقول عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه, والله by Allah, لو طهرت قلوبنا ما شبعنا من كلام ربنا. The issue is here. The medium is not ready. القلب still consumed with the dunya. Still consumed with the dunya. Uthman says, wallahi, if our hearts are clean, we will not have enough from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll always like to hear it. Then تقرأ الآن في الصلاة يا دوبك, something like this. طولت علينا يا شيخ. Too long يا شيخ. قلب. يعني أنا أقص لكم قصة رجل كافر لم يكن مسلم بعد, وقصته في البخاري. His story is in صحيح البخاري. جبير بن مطعم ابن عدي, he came to intercede to free the prisoners of Badr. He says, فدخلت مكة, I entered مكة when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was leading صلاة المغرب and he was reciting سورة الطور. أَمْ تَأْمُرُهُمْ أَحْلَامُهُمْ بِهَذَا أَمْ هُمْ قَوْمٌ طَاغُونَ أَمْ يَقُولُونَ تَقَوَّلَهُ بَلْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ فَلْيَأْتُوا بِحَدِيثٍ مِثْلِهِ إِنْ كَانُوا صَادِقِينَ أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ. How beautiful it is. What about Muhammad? Can you imagine hearing the Quran from Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم? He says, كاد قلبي أن يطير. كافر. Non-Muslim yet. He says, by Allah, upon hearing this, my heart was about to fly out of my chest. إن في ذلك لذكرى. هذا القرآن ذكرى لمن كان له قلب. قلب. إن في ذلك لذكرى لمن كان له قلب. القلب, the medium. The medium is busy. Busy with the dunya, busy with the mal, busy with the wealth, busy with the envy, busy with the hate. لو طهرت قلوبنا ما شبعنا من كلام ربنا. You would wish to listen to it all the time. كلام الله. Speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بل في قصة سورة النجم كما في كتاب التفسير, قرأ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سورة النجم كاملة على الكفار فسجدوا. أفمن هذا الحديث تعجبون وتضحكون ولا تبكون وأنتم سامدون فاسجدوا لله واعبدوا. سجد الكافر. سجد. A disbeliever prostrated. لما جاء الأمر بالسجود من القرآن. فهجر الاستماع. استماع بالقلب. بالقلب. Not only the ear. The second type of abandonment of the Qur'an, brothers and sisters in Islam, هجر التلاوة, abandoning the recitation of the Qur'an, the reading of the Qur'an. We only read it now for the deceased, for the dead. When Allah says in the Qur'an, لِيُنذِرَ مَنْ كَانَ حَيَّا, this book is to warn the living. ما سمعنا أن النبي قرأ القرآن على خديجة, ما سمعنا أن النبي قرأ القرآن على جعفر. We never heard that the Prophet recited the Quran for Khadija, for Ja'far. The Quran is for the living. We only remember the Quran when death. يحكي بعض الإخوة, two brothers, a brother is getting married, brother who follows the Sunnah, follows the Sunnah, ما شاء الله, رجل فاضل. He's playing Quran in his wedding. Somebody was invited. As soon as he arrived by the door, did we come to the wrong place? This must be a funeral. Let's go. ليه يا أخويا؟ ليه القرآن يقرأ؟ في الفرح يقرأ القرآن. هجر التلاوة. والله, a loser who does not recite the Quran. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, والحديث في سنن الدارمي بسند صحيح وسنن الإمام الترمذي من حديث ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه, من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله فله بكل حرف حسنة, لا أقول ألف لام ميم حرف, ولكن ألف حرف ولام حرف وميم حرف. Whosoever reads one letter from the book of Allah, he gets a hasana, and the hasana automatically multiplied 10 times. And I'm not saying alif, lam, mim is one letter, but alif is a letter, lam is a letter, mim is a letter. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim by itself being said sincerely 190 hasana. طبعا في بعض المسلمين دلوقتي يقول لا ما شاء الله انا الحسنات في حسنات انا كويس يا I do other hasanat. يا راجل اتق الله. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لأبي ذر, لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا, لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. Do not belittle a good deed, do not belittle a hasan. Don't say I'm accumulating another hasanat. I do not need the Quran to be a source of hasanat. يا راجل, do not belittle hasanat. ولا أن تلقى أخاك بوجه طليق. يعني some people they meet one another, you're supposed the sunnah that you smile. Why should you smile? Yeah, you get 10 hasana for that smile. Says, no, you know what? No need, I have hasanat. Oh, مغبون هذا. مغبون. قراءة يا إخوة. والله وهذا من فضل الله على هذه الأمة. It's one of the blessings, the bounties of the ummah, that Allah did not say, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say, memorize. He said, just recite it. Just recite it. Yeah. Al-Bukhari wa Muslim, hadith Aisha radiallahu anha, al-mahiru bil-Quran ma'a safarat al-kiram al-barara. In the day of resurrection, the one who has that command of the recitation of the Quran will be in the company of the noble of the angels. طب, what about الأعجمي? Someone who was not given the opportunity. Someone who is not eloquent. وَالَّذِي يَقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنُ وَيُتَعْتِعُ فِيهِ. And the one who recites the Quran and says, بسم الله الرحمن, has two rewards. Two rewards. One for the تَعْتَعَة, one for trying and one for completing. في مسند أحمد وسنن الترمذي حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنه, يقال لصاحب القرآن يوم القيامة, the person who did act upon the Quran and who memorized the Quran, who recited the Quran in the dunya, اقرأ ورتل وارتقي كما كنت ترتل في الدنيا فإن منزلتك عند آخر آية قرأتها. It will be said to the person who recites the Quran over and over again, recite in the day of resurrection and go up into Jannah's 100 level. Your status in Jannah based on the last verse you recited. Wallahi maghboon. Maghboon, a loser, someone who does not recite the Quran. The Quran الآن يا إخوة, very nice. Ya salam, the cover out of this world. But you rather sometimes see people, they come, the Quran is placed in a stand and he does like this. The Quran. Yeah, give me a break, ya Rajin. The Quran is a stone. Quran يقرأ, يتلى, يفهم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, in the day of resurrection, you're going to need help. You're going to need help. You're going to need people to help you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will transform the Quran into a physical form. Allah knows what it is. And it will come and it will intercede for you. Hadith fi Sahih Muslim, hadith Abi Umam al-Bahili, radiyallahu anhu, اقرأوا القرآن فإنه يأتي شفيعا لأصحابه يوم القيامة. Recite the Quran, it will come and intercede for you in the day of resurrection. بل البقرة وآل عمران كأنهما غيامتان أو غيايتان أو فرقان أو حزقان من طير صواف تحاجان عن صاحبهما يوم القيامة. Just البقرة وآل عمران, they will come to intercede for you. Why are we not reciting the Quran? When was the last time you opened the Quran and recited it? When? Allah, ya ikhwa, a month back, a brother, he came to my office. The doctor told him, you have 2 weeks. طبعاً هذا الكلام يعني نعلق عليه دائماً, we comment, your time is in the hands of Allah. But it's good that you have a warning. Do tawbah. Brother who came from overseas to here. Little. You know what he told me? Can I please have a Quran? I given him a Quran. I said, you don't have a Quran? He said, no, but I don't understand it. Just give me a Quran. Wallahi ya ikhwa. This brother, as soon as he hold the Quran, I wish I have more time to recite you. And he started breaking, weeping. I wish I have more time to read you. You know what? He died after 2 weeks. نسأل الله أن يرحمه وأن يغفر له. قرآن يا إخوة, هجر التلاوة. Number 3, هجر التدبر. Abandoning, reflecting upon the Quran. Understanding the Quran. Yes, reciting is an incentive. Hearing it is an incentive. But what is meant really is you learn it. كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليتدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب. A book that we reveal to you, O Muhammad, a blessed one. So for them to reflect upon it. وَعَابَ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ عَلَى هَؤُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ لَا يَتَذَبَّرُونَ أَفَلَا يَتَذَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. Shouldn't they reflect upon the Quran? أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Or their hearts are locked. أَفَلَا يَتَذَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. Shouldn't they reflect upon the Quran? وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. يعني amazing now. الْأُمَّةِ now, brothers, instead of learning the Quran the right way, they follow hearsay explanation of the Quran. يَا إِخْوَةَ, to reflect upon the Quran, to understand the Quran, there is a methodology. And if you cross or override that methodology, you are in trouble. The Quran is to be explained with the Quran. That's step number one. صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. O Allah, guide me to the straight path of those whom you pleased with, or you bestowed your bounty upon. This is Al-Fatiha, is explained in Surah An-Nisa. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. You're asking Allah to guide you to obey Allah and the Messenger. Not a hearsay, not a societal norm. La, Allah and His Messenger. This is the path, the straight path which is you're asking to stick to. And so forth. Al-Quran bil-Quran. If there is nothing that explains the Quran in the Quran, then the one who received the Quran, Rasulullah, Sunnatul Nabi, Al-Hadith, and that goes to those people who say, the Quranites. La ya Habibi. Both are revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given the hadith, the sunnah to explain the Quran. Qala ta'ala, وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الذِّكْرَ لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا نُزِّلَ إِلَيْهِمْ. We reveal to you the sunnah, dhikr here عن sunnah, to explain what's in the Quran. Then if there is nothing in the sunnah, قَوْلُ الصَّحَابِ, the companions, the students of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ما أنت تشوف واحد الآن يجيب لك آية من القرآن. Somebody brings an ayah from the Quran and he speaks about it, his own view. يا سلام. This ayah passed by Abu Bakr, passed by Abu Umar ibn al-Khattab, ibn Jarir al-Tabari, ibn Abi Hatim. خلاص ملهم. هو ملهم. إلهام. فتح. فتح. جالو فتح. Give me a break. فتح قال. يقول لك illumination. I'm inspired. لا يا حبيبي. Quran, Quran, Sunnah, Quran, Sahabi, Quran, Tabi'i, Quran. Then the language explains the Quran. This is how you understand the Quran. A lot of us don't know this. Ibn Kathir, ya ikhwa. Tadabbaru al-Quran. Reflect upon the Quran. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. إن شاء الله tomorrow بإذن الله تعالى between مغرب and عشاء I will cover this in more details and talk about the methodology to explain the Quran in more details, the lecture between مغرب and عشاء. But just to recap quickly, the five abandonments of the Quran: hajru al-tilawah, that hajru al-istima', that you do not listen to it; hajru al-tilawah, that you do not recite it; hajru al-tadabbur, that you do not try, strive to understand its meaning. Number four, hajru al-amali bih wa tahakum ilayh, that you abandon using the Quran to be the judge. Hudud Allah fil Quran, the boundaries of Allah, the implementation of the Quran in our lives. Ya ikhwa, our religion teaches us how to go to the bathroom. Inna hadha al-Quran yahdi lillati hiya aqwam. This Quran will show you the best way to deal with your lives. Number five, hajr al-talawi, that you do not seek remedy with the Quran. And I'm talking about the diseases that affect the hearts: shirk, envy, hate, jealousy, and so forth. The Quran, ya ikhwa, has a cure. We have something called ruqya shar'iyya, al-fatiha, ruqya. Surah al-Baqarah, fiha ayat al-kursi, and the last two verses, wal-mu'awwidhat, qul huwa Allahu ahad. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. This will cure your heart, will cleanse your heart from the diseases. Go back to the Quran, brothers and sisters in Islam. Last Jum'ah, or last week, I was invited to Minnesota, Minneapolis, St. Paul, for the opening of the largest community center in America. 25 acres has football fields, soccer fields, masjid, school. Genders are separated. Teachers are wearing hijab. That's an Islamic school. Hifz program. I walked in that facility to cover the pieces. 45 minutes. Wallahi, ya ikhwan. There is tennis courts. But the one thing that really got my attention is this community, before having this facility, they graduated 78 students memorizing the Quran. 78 students memorized the whole Quran. Colorado, how many we have? How many? It's sad. It is sad. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his farewell speech, he tells his ummah, كما في البخاري, حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص, بلغوا عني ولو آية. Please, deliver this Quran, even one verse. Imagine all of us get to go right now. What are we leaving behind us? For this cause, brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah, we put together a program called the first Taqi program. Taqi, first Hafiz program. Here in Colorado Muslim Society, CMS. And it will be after school. You can bring your children from school to here. But again, we want to make this program affordable to people. We don't want to mark the fee to be so high. Because I'm 100% positive that a lot of the people who qualify to memorize this book belong to parents who need help. Therefore, inshallah, I'm going to stand after the Jum'ah, and maybe in other Jum'ahs, to raise funds for this program. We need to collect some funds. The program, inshallah, will begin on March 5th. Spaces are limited because we have, and this, by the way, goes for boys and girls. Spaces are limited. Find out from the front office how can you register. But before we do this, we have to collect some funds today. Insha'Allah, insha'Allah, a reasonable amount of money in order to subsidize, because we want to hire good teachers, male and females, insha'Allah. And this is nafaqah fi sabilillah, ongoing sadaqah for you. Right after Jum'ah, I will stand up. We want this to take 5 minutes. Brothers and sisters in Islam, you're investing, maybe not in a building, but you're investing in the next generation to leave them with the Quran. Allahumma ij'al al-Quran al-Karim rabi'a qulubina wa jala'a ahzanina wa dhahaba humumina. Allahumma dhakkirna minhu ma nusina wa 'allimna minhu ma jahilna warzuqna tilawatahu ana' al-layl wa atraf an-nahar ala al-wajh alladhi yurdhika 'anna ya rabb al-'alamin. Allahumma inna na'udhu bika min al-fitan ma dhahara minha wa ma batan. اللهم استعملنا ولا تستبدلنا اللهم استعملنا ولا تستبدلنا اللهم وفقنا إلى ما تحب وترضى اللهم خذ بنواصينا إلى الخير اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين في جميع بلاد المسلمين يا رب العالمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي.